you are thankful in the house of God tonight. It's good and pleasant for brethren to dwell together in unity. Oh, God bless us tonight. Draw us near the cross and open our hearts and minds to thy truth. Teach us thy ways, oh God, and make this, most of all, a house of worship tonight. We might meet you here. Oh God, we will thank you for it and praise you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, it's been a good day today. Amen. Amen. I got my dinner and got my nap. God's in his heaven. All is right with the world. Amen. All I need is a good blessing tonight and I'll be all right. Now, that's up to me, right?
Right.
That's up to me to get that. Just reach out and touch the Lord as he goes by. We're going to worship him tonight. Judy's going to come lead us in some congregational songs. Let's get our mind up on the Lord.
Deeper, get out there, get out there. Higher than the world.
Some mud,
So take off your hat. No one take off your coat. Get Ham, Sham, and Jake hat and build yourself a boat. Well, Noah said, Lord, I just don't believe I could. Well, the Lord said, no, you get you some sturdy gopher wood, because you never know what you could do if you try. Make it 50 cubits wide and 30 cubits high. Well, Lord, I'm crazy. She is, Lord.
There she is, Lord.
And the Lord said, Noah, it's time to get aboard. Take you a creature, he and she, and of course, Mrs. Noah and the whole family. Well, Noah said, Lord, it's getting awful dark. Well, the Lord said, Noah, get those creatures in the ark. Well, Noah said, Lord, it's starting to pour. And the Lord said, get in there so I can shut the door. Well, Noah, it rose up from the foot of the deep, and after 40 days, Mr. Noah took a peep. He said, we're not a moving, Lord. Where are we at? Well, the Lord said, no, we're sitting right on top of
my rear rat.
Yeah, but he said, it's getting awful dry. Well, the Lord said, Noah, do you see my rainbow in the sky? Take all these creatures and get down to earth, and don't be more trouble than you were. Well, Noah, I'm grace in the eyes of the Lord.
I might get it, I don't know. Christ is a son over his own house, whose house are we, if we hold fast the
profession or
confidence and hope,
yes,
rejoicing firm unto the end. Well, anyway, what that means is the battles that we fight all the time are just about keeping our faith firm unto the
it's
end.
True.
That's all we have to do if we want to reach glory, is to keep our faith all the way to the end. We're saved by grace through faith.
Yes, sir.
We got to hang on.
Amen.
And the normally, in a war, you fight all these battles to win the war, but the war is already won.
That's right.
You know, Jesus won the war for us. All we have to do is hang on.
Just maintain. That's right.
Hang on. That's what this song is about.
Yes,
amen. Well, I'll tell you what, I done forgot what number it is.
Jennifer made it real plain today.
It's really your wife said two, Joe. I think it's two.
It's wonderful teaching.
So yeah, we'll try two then.
Yes, it was.
Well, I hope she's up. Oh, I don't wish her no bad luck.
I've only sang this song a couple times.
Bless you.
Thousand years ago, outside the eastern gate, they led Jesus to Golgotha's hill. He went there in my place. Across his garden, beaten back, the whole world's sins were torn. Nailed into that rugged tree, where the timbers crossed. That old rugged hill became the battlefield, where the war for the souls of men was fought. Death, hell, and the grave they lost. Victory hung where the timbers crossed. The darkened sky, forsaken for a dead God is, our Lord was crucified. did not the cost. He paid the price for you and me. Where the timbers cross, that old rugged hill became a battlefield. Where the war for the souls of a man. Hell and the grave they lost. Victory hung where the timbers crossed. Jesus paid with his precious life's blood where the timbers crossed.
Pick up the hammer, and it comes back to me every now and then. In this vision, I saw all along the highway. It was a straight highway, and every now and then you'd see a hammer laying alongside the road. And I got up there, and the Lord laid in my heart that people were laying down their hammers. They quit working on the building. You know, you got to keep working on the building.
Yeah, you got to keep working.
You know, you can't lay it down. And I began to preach that, and Tilly, Sister Tilly, went up there. Bless her heart, she'd had a dream about laying her hammer down. And, you know, God will prepare a message just for you.
Sure will.
Did you know that? He'll fix one up just for you.
Yes, he will.
You know, sometimes we say, oh, he's preaching right at me. Maybe so. Maybe so. Maybe someone needed to hear that tonight. Don't lay your hammer down.
Yes. Ain't gonna lay my hammer down.
You gotta occupy till he comes.
Occupy till he comes.
You gotta keep working on the yard. You gotta keep busy. Well, like I said, I never sung this in the shower. It says D. It's real D.
That's what we do it here. Valerie used to sing this quite a lot.
Living below.
Wages.
Never mind about today. Hide your troubles all the way. Don't give up. Just watch and pray and smile it through. You know, God's still in control. Sometimes it don't look like it, but he's in control. Children, we got to believe that to the end. Can you say amen? I'm persuaded we'll look back and smile one of these days and say, he was there all the time. I didn't realize it, but he was right in the middle of it all the time. Praise the Lord. Amen. I got a special request for this song, and I've got to do it. I haven't done it in quite a good while, but it's kind of an easy song to sing. So. Oh, yeah. Amen. If I got the wind to do it. Mama was blessed with the voice of an angel, and softly she sang to me, Rock of Ages, wherefore me? I get to thinking lots of times about back when I was a lad, of the old home place where I grew up, and the days were good and bad. My overalls was hand-me-downs, and my shoes were torn and old, and I had to walk 4 miles every day through the rain, the sleet, and the cold. Well, I've seen the nights my daddy would cry for the things his family would need, but all he ever got was a bad land farm and 700 mouths to feed. And yet our home fires never flickered once. When all these things went wrong, Mama get the hymn book down, and Mama sang a song. What a friend we have, Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to get. Rock to sleep any night to the tune of What a Friend. And come morning, Rock of Ages will wake me gently once again. And then Daddy get the Bible down, he read it loud and long. And I always thought our home was blessed when Daddy'd say, Mama, why don't you sing a song? Precious memories, how they linger. Sister left home first, I guess, and then Phil, then Fred, then Stan. Daddy's health began to fail, and I had to be Mama's little man. But it seemed as Daddy's back grew weak, Mama's faith grew strong. Oh, and then was the greatest days of all, when Mama sang a song. In the sweet fire. The old place is still standing. I don't get back much anymore, but there's no voices left to fill in halls and no steps to grace the floor. Well, you see, my mama's went on to be with Jesus now, around God's golden throne. And I always think this world's a better place. This one time my mama sang a song. Let me hide myself in thee. Song, when I do that song, my mind goes back to our childhood. And you've heard me tell the story of my mom and dad, how they struggled with their salvation. And there was, we was raised up in a lot of tradition, and we was raised under things that we couldn't live up to, and nobody else could either. But we tried, and we tried, and a lot of them struggled, and they'd try for a while, and then they'd fall out of church, and then they'd come back, and they'd come back and try it again. And I watched this go on through the years, and it was way up in their years before they really found grace and understood the grace of God. Because we didn't know anything about the grace of God back in those days. But in the later years, we come to understand. That's called growing in grace and knowledge of the Lord. Amen. And but we didn't know that. We had a lot of rules and bylaws we had to live by, and the can'ts, and you know, can't do this, can't do that, and you got to do this, you got to do that, that type of thing. But God has set us free from those traditions of men. Amen. Now we serve the Lord by the dictates of our heart. And there's a freedom in that. And you've got to grow into that, you know. But I thought about how as children, a lot of times, and you heard me say this at church before, and it always comes back to me when I do that song. Sometimes we'd come home from school, and there'd be a bunch of ladies, and they'd be having a prayer meeting. It wasn't at all unusual. And so we knew not to go in the house or in there, we're praying. And so we'd play out in the yard or whatever. We'd find something to keep us busy. I thought, what a problem for children to have. Don't you wish that's all the problems your children had today? Amen. To come home and find Mama praying with all the ladies of the church. Amen. All that carry on. You could hear them all over the neighborhood. Praise the Lord. And they come out and their eyes would be red where they wipe their eyes. And it's such a great time. Oh, it's so good. How can they be so happy and so sad at the same time, you know? But of course, as I grew older, I understood and realized. But I cherish that in my heart. And I wish our children had that same kind of a heritage. And I think some of us need to start that kind of a heritage. It's called a family altar. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. To teach your children, when you have to send them off into the world, you can send them off with a prayer. I used to call my kids to me and lay hands on them, send them off to school. Yes. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, what a great opportunity we have, children, this day and time. Amen. Amen. Because the enemy is pressing himself down into the earth like a green bay tree. But it's time for the people of God to get a hold of that thing that we had way back to the beginning. Yes. Amen. Get on the rock and really get serious with God. And put God in the center of our life. Oh, if I could hear my mother pray again. You ever hear that song? If I could hear her tender voices then, how happy I would be. 'Twould mean so much to me if I could hear my mother pray again. Hallelujah. Oh, bless the Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Well, I'm full tonight because God is good. And I know Little Donnie's got something for us. I don't know what it's going to be. He probably don't either. But it's all right. Amen. And we're going to just let the Lord have his way. Come on, brother, you got this thing tonight. Thank you, Jesus. God is good.
You know, Sister Wendy got up here last week and she talked about David and Goliath. And I've heard Brother Ronnie speak on it a lot of times, but I've never heard anybody say this. Maybe they have. I ain't been in church all that long. But you know, I always think about when David went out and he slew the bear and he slew the lion. I always just think about how much the Spirit of the Lord came upon him mightily for him to do that. Because that's not even humanly possible. Hallelujah. And I always think about, I was reading today in Judges. I was going back through something I wanted to preach on. And I was reading today in Judges how the Spirit of the Lord always came up on Samson mightily. Yeah, and I was reading that, Sister Denny, I began to shake. I just felt the Holy Ghost fall all over me. Hallelujah. Oh, you know, you know, ever since last Sunday night, I've been praying for me and sister, get up here. Don't get far from me. Hallelujah. Give me your hand if that's okay. But as I started praying last week for God to anoint us, I said, Lord, I want you to use us. Let our spirit become one. And let the Spirit of the Lord come upon us mightily. Hallelujah. And Lord, let us connect. And you let miracles take place. And you fill our mouth. And you let God have his way. Because it's not us. It's only God. Not by my spirit, saith the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. I'm praising him tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh.
You want to say anything?
I praise God for his mercy. I praise him for his goodness. I praise him for the word that he's deep within us. I asked Brother John, I said, you got something you want to talk about? He said, I want to talk about the word. Put in the word deep within your heart. And I prayed about that all week. You know, We've got to have that written word of God deep within your heart. I'm telling you, if you do not know the word, if you do not know the word, this world will deceive you. It will fool you. It will deceive you. It will make you doubt. I'm going to tell you right now, you cannot convince me that 2 + 2 is nothing less than 4.
That's right. Amen.
I know that if I have 2 apples and 2 apples, I've got 4 apples. Uh-huh. I don't care how you arrange it, how you set them up and down.
Yeah.
2 + 2 is 4. Uh-huh. I know this. You know. Can anybody convince you that it's not?
No.
There's no way, because you know that you know that you know that you know that you know.
Amen.
And I know that God is the deliverer.
Ah.
I know that God can do all things.
Yes, he can.
But you've got to have that word
Amen.
Written
Absolutely.
On your heart.
Yeah.
You've got to know it frontwards,
yes,
backwards.
Yes.
You cannot allow the enemy to deceive
uh-huh.
you in any way.
Amen.
Amen.
And that's what he's out for.
Yeah, he's alive.
He is out there to steal, kill, and destroy.
Destroy.
Yes, he
you've
is.
Got to hold fast, stand fast on what you know
yes.
is true.
Amen.
Read this word. Know this word. Understand Amen. This word. You've got to have. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, I was on my way home from church today, and we got about halfway to Bloomington. And I was feeling God so strong, I said, I'm ready to preach right now. I said, I want to preach right now. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I was sitting back there tonight, and I was about to bust. I said, if I don't get to get up there pretty soon and say something or do something, I said, I'm going to bust wide open. Hallelujah. That's how much I've sought God and seeking this week, Brother Pat. Hallelujah. You know, as I was reading the scriptures this week, I realized I don't know nothing. Hallelujah. But I'm going to keep on standing on what I know. I'm going to keep on writing it in my heart. Hallelujah.
I'm going to
keep on speaking it out. I love you tonight. Oh, hallelujah. You got anything else?
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord.
You know, I love the ministries in this church. I love all the different ones. You know, I was listening to Sister Jennifer this morning. I said, Lord, just let me have a little bit of her teaching to go with my exhortation. Hallelujah.
Yes. Amen.
And I said, give her a little bit of my exhortation to go with her teaching. Hallelujah. And I've seen it come out of her before. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But I love God. Brother Mark, he's done such a good job this morning.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Did.
Amen. And I love each and every one of you. It's just a good to be in the family of God.
Amen.
That we're, no one's jealous of one another's
yes.
ministry. That we can all get behind one another. That we can lift them up. Not be jealous. Hallelujah. I'm getting blessed, and I hope God uses me that you're getting blessed.
Amen. Preach on, brother.
And you know, I'm trying to slow down tonight.
You're good.
Brother Pat, because you said the Spirit's subject unto the prophet.
Yes.
You know, and I love the jumping and the shouting because I'm feeling God mightily when that's going on. But also, I get back in my seat a lot of times when I get up here. And I get back here and I start remembering the things I want to say. Then I get mad at myself because I want to get it out. Hallelujah. But I appreciate you, Brother Pat, for letting me get up here and take the time to preach. I appreciate that you got confidence in me to let me get up here and preach. Hallelujah. And one thing I want to say tonight, you know, my dad didn't believe in women preachers, for the ones of you who don't know me tonight. And most of you just heard this, but I got to say this tonight before I go on. Because I would not sit under a woman preacher.
Uh-huh.
When I first come to this church, I asked Brother Mark, I said, you let me know when that blonde's preaching. Because I said, I am not going to come and sit under her. But over the time, then sometimes I would come, Brother Pat something come up, he wasn't teaching. Or Brother Jerry, so Sister Jennifer was. And you know, I sat back here behind her, or I used to sit over here where Brother Raymond is, or Brother Bobby, and when she'd be over there praying, I could just start feeling the power of God on her, Brother Pat. You could just feel the Holy Ghost moving. I mean, I could feel it coming across and touching me. Or when she'd be up here teaching, she'd go back and pray for someone, you could just feel the power of God moving. Now, I got to thinking about that. I said, well, God, how can that be? If you can't use a woman, why am I feeling the Holy Ghost like that off of her? And see, and I got to praying about it, Sister Daisy. Oh, see, because there's neither male nor female in Christ Jesus. For a woman and spirit, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm glad I come to that understanding. Hallelujah.
Mary.
God is good.
Yes,
I'm
going
to read now chapter 3. I'm going to read a couple scriptures here. I got a few places I want to go. In chapter 3, verse 1.
Where you at?
Chapter 3, Proverbs, I'm sorry. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 1. My wife tells me I need to slow down.
Okay.
Okay.
She said, I get up here and read so fast, nobody can keep up with me. But that's what I want to preach, what Sister Jennifer was talking about. Write it in your heart.
Amen.
You know, I quote scriptures. I'll give you the chapter and verse, and that's nothing for me. You know, that's nothing, Brother Pat. Maybe I listen to you and Sister Jennifer. You guys know more word than I ever thought about. I hear the word coming out of you all the time. I'm amazed at the word I hear. But see, you don't want to get jealous, because that's just the way God gave it to me. He gives it to you another way. He'll give it to someone else another way. But just by us being sitting here in the house of God, and when we're hearing the word of God, it gets written down in our hearts. Maybe he does it different for me, or maybe he does it different for you. But just don't get jealous of one another. Let's just let God use them the way he's put it on.
Amen.
But it says, my son, forget not my law, but let thine heart keep my commandments.
Amen.
And I'm going to switch over here right quick to Proverbs 4 and read a couple other scriptures. Verse 20, it says, my son, attend unto my words, incline thy ear unto my sayings. Let them not depart from thine eyes, keep them in the midst of thine heart. Hallelujah. So let's write it on our heart. Hallelujah. I love this next scripture for you. They are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh. Hallelujah. And I know this to be true, and I've testified about this before, and here I'm going to talk on it again. I used to worry about repeating myself in church, but I get to listen to Sister Jennifer and Brother Pat, Brother Jerry, Brother Ronnie, all the different preachers. Well, from time to time, they come back and preach what they preached on before.
Oh, absolutely.
So I quit worrying about that, Sister Daisy. If God puts it on me again, I'm going to talk on it again. Hallelujah.
Absolutely.
Don't
worry.
Where's your life? Amen.
Yeah.
But you know, I love quoting the Word of God. I believe it's a gift that God has given me. I asked for it the night I got saved. I said, Lord, I want a double portion of what my dad's got. And it, you know, I've learned too, it's not about how many scriptures. If I went through here and learned this whole Bible and had no understanding of the Word, it wouldn't do me no good at all.
No good.
Good. The only scriptures I write in my heart is one that I feel that I could talk on, or I got a little bit of understanding on it. Hallelujah. I mean, if I want to sit down, I could quote whole chapters to you, but it wouldn't do me any good if I didn't have no understanding of it. Hallelujah.
Right.
But I do what God does right in my heart. I love using it. You know, it says in Psalms 119:11, thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. I just love that verse right there, Brother Pat. Hallelujah, because it'll save us in the time of trouble. Hallelujah. It'll keep us from sinning. Hallelujah. It'll keep us from stepping out and doing wrong when we know we shouldn't do it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
All right, let's go back to chapter 3, verse 1. My son, forget not my law, but let thy heart keep my commandments. And I was praying over this week, this scripture right here. It came to me, sometimes the things we go through is because we break the commandments of God. A lot of times we do things that we know it's wrong, but we go ahead and do it anyway. Is anybody guilty of that besides me?
Yeah.
I've been guilty of it. Here a few, or maybe a month ago, the Lord told me absolutely not to do something. And I wanted something, he said, do not do it. And I went on and done it anyway, because I wanted that thing that I wanted. And I'm not going to tell you what it was, but I wanted it. And every time Sister Daisy went to try to get it, it wasn't there. I waited and waited a week. 2 weeks went by and they still didn't have it. Finally, I come to Martinsville, found one and they had it. And then when I bought it, went to use it that night, it was broke. Brand new. That right then should have told me to leave it alone. But old stubborn Donnie, he's still going to get that some way. Hallelujah. And I've been taking a good whipping for it too. Don't think I ain't. And we will when we break the commandments of God. If we know to do something, don't do it. Or if he tells us not to do something, we go do it. And I think a lot about Samson on this right here. You know how he was told to never cut his hair? Because it was a commandment. You may disagree with me on this right here, and that's fine. It never was Samson's hair that gave him his strength.
No.
It was always as the Spirit of the Lord came upon him mightily. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Right, yes.
And it just amazes me. And that's what I've been praying for this week for me and Sister Jennifer, for God to come upon us mightily. Let the Spirit of the Lord arise up. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But you know, I think about Samson, after they poked his eyes out, and how he broke the commandment of God, and when he went to that grinder, and I'm sure, I just picture you walking around, pushing all day long.
Oh, yes.
And you know, and I'm sure when he was pushing that around, he thought back, why? did I go and associate with the Philistines?
Yes.
Why didn't I stay in my own tribe?
No doubt.
Why didn't
no
I get a wife that was in my own place where my mother and father wanted me to?
No.
Why did I let Delilah deceive me from her beauty and everything?
Uh-huh.
Oh, if I'd have just listened to God, hallelujah, I wouldn't be where I'm at today, hallelujah. See, so many times we don't listen to God and we get in trouble. And I believe a lot of us are at that grinding mill.
Yeah.
And I believe right at that time when Samson was at that grinding mill, he seen more clearly right then than he ever seen in his life. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You want to say anything else right now? Well, I want you to come in here too. Will you just stay back there and pray for me while you're doing that?
Preach on, brother. Preach on.
You know, Brother Ronnie's always encouraged me. When he called me a bad cop a while ago, I thought about when I got up here, so I'd like for some of you, my deputies, come and escort him out of here. Love you, Brother Ronnie.
I'm trying real hard.
Then you'd had a reason to really think I was a bad cop. I'm just teasing you. The next verse says, "For length of days and long life and peace shall they add to thee." See, there's a threefold blessing right here in this verse.
Yes,
length of days, long life, and peace. Hallelujah. And I know this length of days to be true. Brother Pat told me once, when my dad first died, I could not get up here and talk without crying. I may shed a tear here a few, I don't know.
Go right ahead.
But if I broke down, I'll leave it alone. But Brother Pat told me once, I broke down back here crying, sitting right to my dad, and I said, "One day you'll be able to talk about it."
That's right.
Without breaking down.
Yeah.
I said, "I don't know how, but you was right, Brother Pat." Because I can talk about
God,
it now.
He does so hard. He does.
Without breaking down. You know, you never quit loving your dad or mom.
No.
No.
You always love them.
Yes.
Amen.
You never get over them. You just learn to go on.
That's it.
And no matter what we go through, we just got to learn to go on.
Amen.
Because God sees the full picture
that
we don't
does.
See. I've been going
Absolutely.
Through stuff, me and my wife, for the last 5 years. And I question myself, "Lord, what am I doing wrong? I think, am I sitting in the wrong church? Do you want me somewhere else, Lord?" Sometimes I sit here, and Brother Pat's got so many ministers to help him out. And I said, "Do I need to be here?" I said,
"Yes,
I said,
be here."
I said, "He could do without me. I could go find a church that needs more help than Brother Pat does." I said, "They got good music, and he's got plenty of young ministers, and I love to hear each and every one of them. You bless me every time you preach. Hallelujah." But length of days, let me get back to where I want to be. But for length of days, and I know this to be true when my dad was sick. Because when he got sick, I'd only been saved a year and a half. And I didn't know a lot of scriptures at that time. But when he was sick, he had gangrene in his foot. Uh-huh. And it was eating his foot off, little by little. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And I couldn't understand why that was happening at the time. But I know length of days was added to him over our prayers. Me getting in his word, praying and fasting for him, it gave him days when he should have died in 3 days, Sister Daisy.
Yeah.
He lived 6 weeks longer. You know, I got to sit there and talk to him about the Lord. I got to go in his room every night when it stunk so bad. He's talking about your foot stinking. Brother, my dad's foot stunk so bad I could not hardly stand to sit in that room with him. But by the grace of God, I sat there all night long with him. And you, Brother Pat, said here all back the other day or last Sunday that you've learned things. I have learned things.
Yes, yes.
God taught me how to pray during that time, Sister Daisy. I didn't know how to pray till then.
Amen.
But I reached down and got a hold of God.
Oh,
hallelujah.
Yes.
That's what it'll do when you write this word in your heart.
Right.
It'll add length of days to you.
Yeah.
The word was in my dad's heart too. And we prayed 6 weeks he lived like that, Sister Daisy.
Yeah.
Then one day I said, "Lord, I couldn't stand." I mean, he would scream so loud at night. It was just something. Every time you just jump when he'd start screaming, Sister Daisy. Oh. But we prayed and it kept him alive. Then one day I finally came to realize I fasted. I went on a 3-day fast. I hadn't been saved long at that time. And I read where Esther fasted 3 days and saved Mordecai's life. So I went on a 3-day fast, hoping that would save my dad's life, and it still didn't work. So the next time I did a 7-day fast and I'd eat nothing, and he was still getting worse. Then all the family was taking a day each of fasting. Then I went on a 5-day fast. And on that 5th day, Sister Daisy, I said, "Lord, if you're not going to heal him," I was sitting in a room praying for him. I said, "If you're not going to heal him, take him on home. Yeah. I'm tired of seeing him suffer. I can't take it no more. And about 5 minutes later, God took him home. Yeah. And I wouldn't call him back for nothing today because the God has healed me.
I understand that.
Amen.
Amen.
It's what I did with my daughter. Amen.
Hallelujah.
What you got to do.
Hallelujah. If you only knew that all the times I told my wife I'm not preaching no more, I'm not exhorting no more. If they call on me, I'll get up and go out the door. But there's just something down in you.
Something within.
You can just sit there and feel the fire burn. Oh, hallelujah. This is the only time I'm happy. This is when I feel no pain. This is when I feel that I'm holding God's hand. You know, he's right there with us. Hallelujah. Right there with us, sister. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, come on, you say something.
Right, God is with us. We have to be willing. You had to be willing on that fifth day to say, Lord,
take
him home.
Not
my will, Lord, but your will. So much of the time we say, okay, Lord, I figured this all out. This is how you need to do it.
Yeah.
And God is sitting back and he's saying, no, that's not the way we're going to do it. But we want it done our way.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen. Yeah. You know, I'm sure, I'm with you. I don't believe that the strength of Samson was actually in his hair. I think it was because he was given a commandment.
Yeah.
He was given a commandment. Yeah. And when he let the wiles of that woman, the wiles of that woman come in and deceive him, and when she cut off his hair, and he lost his strength. And you know what? What the enemy was going to use for evil, God turned around and made it for good.
Amen.
Right. And that's a way in our life. If you can just understand, whatever the enemy has set out for evil against you, God will take and turn it around.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
All things work together for the good of those that love God and are thee called according to his purpose.
Amen.
His purpose is not my purpose.
Right.
And his purpose,
amen.
His purpose is to glorify him.
Amen.
It's not in what we have. It's not in our stature. It's not in anything that we can have here on this earth. But it's all in him. Everything that you go through, we go through that somehow God might get the glory. I don't understand why bad things happen to good people. I don't know. I don't understand why your dad had to go through. Because I know he was a man of faith. And he said, God's going to heal me. God's going to heal me. And he stood, and he stood, and he believed God.
Yes.
And you know what? I find no fault in that.
That's right.
How
Amen.
Can you find fault in somebody
no.
whose faith is totally
Amen.
And completely in God?
Right. Amen.
Because he believed God, and he spoke that word, and he quoted that word, and he trusted that word. And ultimately, his faith was in God.
Amen.
And when you said, okay, Lord, if it's your will, then just take him home. And your prayer was answered.
Amen.
Finally, you got in that room with God.
Yes.
Finally, you got in that will of
Amen.
God.
Amen.
And if we can get in that will of God,
yes.
if we can just get in that will of God,
Amen.
You can ask what you
will.
Want,
yes.
and you receive it.
Amen.
You receive not because you ask not. And when you ask, you ask
him this.
You ask it upon your own fleshly lust.
Yeah.
You're not asking for these things that God might get glory.
No.
Most of the time, we ask things because we think it's necessary.
That's right.
We think it's needful. This is what we need. When you don't even know what you
That's
need.
Right.
That's right.
You don't even know your own
That's
heart.
The
Word of God says, you don't even know your
yeah.
own heart.
That's true.
Right, man.
We think we do.
Uh-huh.
Oh, and people that say, but God knows my heart.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
He does.
Oh, yeah. When you say that, he knows your heart.
Yeah.
He knows where you're at.
Yeah.
Oh, and you know, I'm just so glad that I know
oh.
that whatever the enemy says
yeah.
for evil, God will take that
and
he'll turn it around. Because I want
yeah.
you to know, when Brother Joe got up here tonight and he's talking about a warfare, the war has already been won.
Yes.
The war has already been
That's
won.
Right.
The devil just doesn't know it.
He don't know it.
He just doesn't
he's
know
stupid.
It. He's stupid. The thing is he thinks, I'm going to take down as many people as I can.
Sure, that's your job.
So battle after battle after battle after battle. Do you realize in World War II, there were a lot of battles that were lost?
Yep.
There were a lot of battles that was lost,
yep.
but the war was won.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Yes.
We fight different battles all the time, and sometimes the enemy just knocks us down. Face it, when he got Samson, they cut his hair, they poked out his eyes, And you know what? I'm like you. I think he could see more clear with his eyes poked out than he could ever have seen with true vision. Because you know what? We have tunnel vision. We see things the way we want to see them. We have tunnel vision. This is how my life needs to be. This is how it's going to be. But you know what? When that was taken away from him, he had to totally, completely give himself over to God. Whatever, Lord. Whatever. I am your servant. Whatever you want me to do. And I'm with you. I believe that when he was on that grinding wheel, every turn of the wheel, he said, all right, Lord, whatever you say. All right, Lord, whatever you want me to do. Okay, Lord. I mean, I know I've messed up. I know I've made mistakes. But, Lord, I'm not going to miss it. I'm totally yours. I'm completely yours. I'm giving it all over to you right now. And what the enemy sought for evil, God totally turned around for good. And there was an entire people that were completely killed. All the Philistines that were in that building because Samson said, here it is, Lord. Whatever you want.
I give it all to you.
You know, because somehow in that period of time, God wrote that word on his heart and said, no matter where you're at, no matter what you're going through, no matter what it looks like, I'm with you. I'm with you. And what the enemy seeks for evil, God will turn to good. But you've got to know that he's in control.
Absolutely.
You have to know that God is in control. Samson came to a conclusion. Not my life. Not my will, but yours, Lord.
Exactly.
Whatever you want me to do, wherever you want me to go, I'm going to do what you called me to do. And that's what we have to come to. We have to come to that understanding. No matter what, Lord, I'm going to follow after you. No matter what, Lord, help me to see you. No matter what, Lord, help me to understand that if you're for me, nothing can be against
me. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
See, John 15:7 said, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Hallelujah. Amen. See, when Samson got back to on that grinding wheel, he turned his life completely back to God then.
Yes.
He was totally sold out to him then.
Yes.
And that's why when his hair started to grow a little bit, God honored his word, his commandment that he gave. If you don't cut your hair, then he... See, it never was the hair, because he started praying to the Lord. I had it all marked down. I was going to read it, but I ain't going to go to it. Then he started praying. He said, oh, God, just give me my strength one more time.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
See, he totally sold out. And that's when he had all of his might, and he could break in pillars in two so it would come down. Hallelujah.
Church,
wow. You know, here a while back, I was coming to church, and my truck grounded out. I need to change the distributor on it and stuff, because when it gets wet, it grounds out. And usually if it starts, I'm all right, but it was raining and everything when I come, and it got wet and ground out, and I knew it wasn't going to start. I called my cousin to come and get me, because when it doesn't, it will not start. And I was sitting there praying, and that scripture came to me. I just quote John 15, said, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. I said, all right, Lord. I said, I believe I abide in you. And I said, all the word you've wrote in my heart, I believe it abides in me. Now I'm asking you in the name of Jesus Christ to let this truck start so I can get on to church. And I tried it again, that fired right up, brother. And I never missed it. To do when you write the word in your heart. And in a time of trouble, you can call on God. You can't always call on Brother Pat or Sister Jennifer or some of us preachers or anyone in the church. You need to get it wrote down in your heart. It'll save your life.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
I've told about this before. I was coming down 37 one day. I was working up north here at Martinsville doing a house, and I have high blood pressure, and I'm believing God's going to heal it. I stand on his word, and I am healed. Hallelujah. But my face started tingling real bad, and my bottom lip went numb, Brother Pat. And I started quoting the Psalms 91. It says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Brother Ronnie preached on night, he that abides in that secret place.
Yes.
But I changed. I said, I dwell in the secret place of the Most High. I abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Then I said, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Hallelujah. When I got to my God, Sister Daisy, the lip came back. I had the feeling, the tingling stop. And I said, oh, thank you, Jesus. So we need to write it in our hearts so we can call upon as many times as we need to.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
The word will do the job.
The third verse says, let not mercy and truth forsake thee. bind them about thy neck, write them up on the table of thine heart. And that's what we've just been talking about, is write it up on our heart.
Right.
Then the fourth verse says, so shalt thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and man. You know, and I know this to be true. I know when you get in this word and you seek God, and not just read his word. I found out when you read his word and study, that ain't enough. You got to pray over them scriptures. Hallelujah.
Yes,
it says, Lord, open my eyes and give me understanding. Hallelujah. That I can help someone else with it. That I have understanding with it. Hallelujah.
Yes.
But don't think the devil won't come along and try to steal your praise. Hallelujah. I'm going to say something here, and I hope nobody takes it wrong. Here, while back, we hear a lot that it's not always in the shout and the dance. Brother Pat says it, Brother Ronnie says it, and different people say it. And it's took me a long time to figure that out, why you guys say that. Because sometimes when you say that, I say, well, are they telling me I'm in my flesh sometimes when I get up? And it got me down. See, I let the devil get in there. And it got me down. Like Sister Day, she told me her day, I called her and talked to her. She said, why do you keep letting the enemy beat you up all the time? She said, well, you quit doing that. And I said, I'll try. But here's what I want to say about it. I understand what you're saying. It's not always in the shout and the dance.
Right. No, it's not.
But that's sometimes my calling. That's how God uses me. Even when I'm up shouting and running and screaming and crying and hollering and jumping up and down, I feel God reaching his arms right around me. And a lot of times in that shouting and running, you can hear that still small voice right in that shouting and running. Hallelujah. That'd be like somebody coming in and telling Brother Pat that picking a guitar and singing is not in his ministry. Oh, yes, it is. That's something that God gave him to go along with his preaching. Hallelujah. See, God uses every one of us different ways. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Absolutely.
I just had, you know, it says confess your faults one another and pray for one another that you may be healed.
Right.
Sometimes we need to just get up here and let the people know what we're going through. Hallelujah.
Right.
So they can pray for us and help us. Hallelujah.
Don't hurt.
Sure.
Well,
takes the wind.
Now I'm going to go to Deuteronomy. Chapter 11.
Patience, good for
you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You know, Jeremiah 29:13 says, and you shall seek me and find me when you shall search for me with all your heart.
Yes.
See, God wants our whole heart. He wants everything we got.
That's right.
And when we get to reading his word and studying it, he'll start revealing things to us. Hallelujah. But Deuteronomy 11, verse 19, I'm going to read there. And ye shall teach them your children, speaking of them, when thou sittest in thy house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. I don't see where it gives us any other time for anything else. I mean, I know that we can keep God in our mind all day long, even on the job. Sister Daisy got before and told him about praying without ceasing.
Yeah.
That's what we need to do.
Yes.
We need to get it in our heart. We need to pray all day long. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Then you talk about the blessings of God. I'm getting ahead of myself. Hallelujah. It goes on to say, and thou shalt write them up on the doorpost of thine house and up on thy gates, that your days may be multiplied and the days of your children. Oh, I just love this every time I do it, that your days may be multiplied and the days of your children. See, when we write this in our heart, we can multiply our days upon this earth. Hallelujah. There's another scripture where it gives us what we can multiply our days. In Ephesians 6 and 1, it says, honor thy father and mother, for this is the first commandment with a promise. First commandment with the promise. That thou mayest live long upon the earth. See, we got a promise right there. If we honor our father and mother, I believe when children rise up against their parents, curse them and put them down and don't obey them, I believe they're shortening their days. I believe they're taking days off their life. Hallelujah. I love my dad. I didn't always agree with him. There's a lot of times I didn't agree with him. Hallelujah. But I never spoke back to him. I would just walk away. I wouldn't argue with him. My mom, the same way. I love her. Hallelujah. I wish she was here tonight. But I honor her. I respect her. I respect my elders. That's something the children need to do now. They need to learn to respect their elders. It don't matter if it's their mom and dad. I'm getting off of that. Hallelujah.
Anyway.
I'm not saying anything else.
All right. That's the truth anyhow.
Yes, it is
true.
I mean, I raised my kids to mine. I made them respect their aunts and uncles. I made them respect. I'm getting off of it. Hallelujah.
Whole another message.
I'm about done. Let's go down to the 26th verse. It says, behold, I set before you this day a blessing and a curse.
Oh, yes.
A blessing if you obey the commandments of the Lord God, which I command you this day. And a curse if you will not obey the commandments of the Lord your God. You know, it's time, and I'm not saying we don't do it, but I'm saying it's time that we need to get sold out. I don't believe there's no one in this church completely sold out for God.
Go ahead, brother.
I don't believe there's not a one of us.
Have to.
I found out this week through praying and fasting, I cannot believe how much I felt the Lord all week from sickening continually, Sister Daisy. I mean, I could just feel the anointing on Him. I could just feel Him walking with me, hallelujah. Yes. I could just feel it rising up in me, hallelujah.
Draw near to Him.
And we need to get into God's Word and read His Scriptures.
Yes.
And we need to pray over Him. Then I believe that the blessings of God are going to come upon us, Brother Pat.
Yes, sir.
I believe they will come out. Come here, Sister Jennifer. I'm going to have you run in a minute. I'm going to come after you.
Go, Jennifer.
Now, don't trip. I'm just going to try to grab you by the shoulders. But anyway, I believe when we get a hold of God and start reading His Word and studying it and pray over it and say, Lord, show me the way that the blessings of God will chase you down. Take off. See, the blessings of God. They will chase you down and overtake you.
Amen.
You can close this out for me, sister. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
That's good, brother. That's
I thank
good.
God. I praise Him so much.
Not that easy.
If you would please turn to Ephesians chapter 6 for just 1 second, please. Ephesians chapter 6. Starting at verse 10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand, stand.
Amen.
Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. He wants you to enter into that place of protection. Again, we are in a war. And when you are in battle, you better have on your weapons of warfare.
Amen.
If you do not have your weapons of warfare, the enemy's going to walk all over you.
Yes, he will.
He will walk. I guarantee you, there is not a soldier in Iraq that's going to go out in a pair of jeans and a t-shirt.
That's right.
There's no way.
That's
he's
right.
going to have on his armor.
Yes.
He's going to be. He's going to have his gun. He's going to be in an armor-plated Humvee. Whatever it takes, he's going to put on that protection because
Amen.
He knows what he's fighting.
Yes. Amen.
You need to know today what you're up against.
Yes. Amen.
You are up against an enemy that wants to kill you.
Yes, he does.
He wants to put seeds of doubt within you that will make you think, oh, see, they kept telling you it's going to be okay. It's going to be okay. Now look where you're at. It does not matter where we're at.
That's right.
Because again, like I said this morning, this world is not our home.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
We're not seeking to live on this earth for eternity.
That's right. No.
Amen.
We're seeking a home and builder and maker who is God.
Amen.
That's what we're searching for.
Yes.
You cannot get too comfortable in this world.
No, you can't.
If you get too comfortable and you say, oh, but I go to church here and I pray every now and then, and sometimes I... Not what God wants for you.
That's right.
God wants you to be completely covered. He wants you to put on that helmet of salvation.
Yes.
He wants that breastplate of righteousness. He wants that in so that you're not heart. Tell you what, you get shot in the heart, you're dead, man.
Yeah.
That's all there is to it. And so He wants you to put on that protection.
Yes.
He wants you to have truth. He wants you to take that sword of the Spirit, which can cut one way and heal the other.
Yes, it can.
He wants you to be prepared. He wants you to have on that armor.
Amen.
He wants you to not be deceived by this world.
Amen.
And that's what they want. They want to deceive you into thinking that God's went on a journey. He's on vacation. And he's not on vacation.
No.
He is with you.
Hallelujah.
Every day.
Amen.
If you do not turn to him, there is nothing he can do. Do you understand? God wants to bless his people. But if you don't open up yourself to him,
amen.
He can't do anything.
No, he can't.
Yeah. I heard his brother say tonight that the spirit is subject unto the prophet.
Amen. Yes.
The spirit is subject unto the prophet. Sister Daisy taught a wonderful message one day. God is a gentleman.
Yes.
And he will force nothing on no one.
That's right.
He wants you to enter into that place. He wants you to come to that place where you have that peace. And you have that joy, and you have that understanding that he will be with you no matter what.
Amen.
Absolutely.
And he wants you to be prepared for battle. He wants you to have that word written in your heart.
Amen.
He wants you to know that he is for you.
Oh, and not against
Brother
you.
Donnie,
praise
I love
God.
God
tonight.
I'm
crazy.
And he is a good God, and he wants so much for you.
Yes.
He just wants you to open yourself up to him.
Yes.
Just open yourself up to him.
Oh.
Just give him an opportunity.
Oh, okay.
If you just give
don't
him
send
an opportunity,
them out there right away.
His word says, try me and see.
Try
me and see. If you just try him. You know, if you just try him, what is it? Try it, you'll like it.
Try
it, you'll like it.
Taste and see that the Lord is
good. He is good.
Yes,
he is good. And he is loving. And he is merciful. And he just wants to give to you so much. But you've got to be willing to push aside your feelings.
Yes.
Like Brother Donnie said tonight, he that knoweth to doeth good,
and doeth it not.
To him it is sin.
Right.
Brother Pat may be able to do a lot of things that I can't do. You know, Brother Louie may be able to do a lot of things that Brother Ronnie can't do. You have to work out your own salvation with God.
Amen.
You have to work it out. But you have to listen to him when he's calling.
Yes.
He will call you into a place that you've never been before.
Amen.
You just have to be willing to open your heart up and listen to him and receive him. I love you.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.